山间为神发问，济劫众生，请转妙法轮，教导我们如何了生脱死离苦得乐，速证无上。The with rivers to out of compassion, for the sake of his assembly and all living beings, please turn the wonderful Dharma wheel to teach us how to leave suffering and attain bliss in birth and death, and quickly realize number.
Namo Sadanto Suche Doye Arahati Samyang Sambutto Xie. Namo Sadanto Suche Doye Arahati Samyang Sambutto Xie. Namo Sadanto Suche Doye Arahati Samyang Sambutto Xie. Namo Lianchi Hai Hui Fo Pusa. Namo Lianchi Hai Hui Fo Pusa. Namo Lianchi Hai Hui Fo Pusa.
Namo Sivas Lotus Pool Assembly of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas.
无上甚深微妙法，百千万劫难遭遇。我今见闻得受持，愿解如来真实义。
The unsurpassed, profound, and wonderful Dharma is difficult to encounter in hundreds of millions of eons. I now see and hear it, receive and uphold it, and I vow to truly understand the Tathagata's true meaning.
Jumpa Pusa, 然后呢，在很早期在那边先学佛，然后呢，听到上人读到上人的书，还有那个真修行者的消息，就申请去台湾正法佛学院那带一个签证，然后读完了以后就问上人可不可以来圣城，上人说可以然后呢所以不久就来了圣城，在1990年三月份来圣城，因为他是收到一个全额的法大的奖学金，还有签证来读法大法界佛教大学。然后呢，在三月来了，四月就剃度出家了，然后之后就我们都很熟悉每年的万佛忏，都是有衡阳师来做维罗，然后呢常常讲法，提倡净土法门，还有很多不同的经典。那我们今天很高兴，不要再用时间。So we're very happy to have Dharma Master Yang today to speak Dharma for us. And for those who don't know her, she's from Malaysia.And first heard about Venerable Master and applied to go to the Proper Dharma Buddhist Academy in Taiwan to study for a short term, where she got permission from Venerable Master to come to the city of 10,000 Buddhas. And so shortly thereafter, after actually a lot of praying to Earthstar Bodhisattva, she got a full scholarship to DRBU, Dharma Realm Buddhist University, and the visa. So she came in March of 1990, and a month later, she left the home life. And since then, she has been, we have been very familiar that she came to lead the 10,000 Buddhas repentance at City of 10,000 Buddhas pretty much every year, and also promotes Pure Land Dharma Door and many Mahayana Sutras. So we welcome Yang Fa Shi. Amitofo.
Amitofo. 诸佛菩萨、师父、上人、各位法师、各位善知识，今天呢，轮到恒阳在这里跟连续两个星期天跟大家一起学习佛法。那这一次呢的题目呢是把死当毕业，平生努力应考。
Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, Spiritual Master, Dhamma Masters, and all good wise advisors, Amitofo. This is Hengyang. It is for two consecutive Sundays. We'll be learning the Buddha Dharma with everyone. So today's topic is everything in life is a test. Death is your graduation.
首先先给大家看一段《无量寿经》的经文。你们方便的话可以合掌一起跟我读佛说无量寿经卷下的一段文。人在世间爱欲之中，独生独死，独去独来，当行至去苦乐之地，身自当知无有待者。
We would like to recite a passage from the Buddha Speaks of Infinite Life Sutra. If it's convenient for you, you could put your palms together and recite with us. In the midst of the worldly loves and desires, one comes and goes alone. One is born alone, dies alone. After death, one goes to a painful or to a pleasant state of existence. Each receives his karmic consequences, and nobody else can take his place.
在六道当中呢，人道呢是属于一个转站。我们来到做人呢，这时候呢，佛经是说我们都是两个字推动我们活下去的啦，就是这个爱欲。然后呢，出世也因为爱欲而来投胎，死的时候呢，也是因为爱欲拼了 一生的命，到最后呢，也搞坏了身体了，时间到了就得死。但是呢，从始至终都是独生独死，独去独来，你一个人来，你一个人走，没有人会陪你。可是走的时候呢，你走去哪里呢？看你个人在这一生当中所造的业善多还是恶多，还是清净业、所以他说当你走到去向苦乐之地的时候呢，到时候是自己要承担，没有人可以代替你去那个苦或者乐的地点。
Okay, so it says that when we come to this world as a human being, the human path is actually a transfer station. What really propels us to live in this world is our love and desires. So we are born because of love and desires. We die due to love and desires too. So our body eventually will decay and then we pass away. So it says that amidst of worldly loves and desires, one comes alone and goes alone. One is born alone and one dies alone. So when we come by ourselves. No one can accompany us. So when we die, where do we go? It really depends on our karma, whether it's wholesome karma, how much wholesome karma, how much pure karma, how much evil or negative karma. So then it says, that one goes to a painful or a pleasant state of existence by ourselves. No one can really stand in for us. No one can really take our place.
那我们呢，今天的题目就是把死当毕业日，平生努力应考。很明显的呢，就是指的是念佛人，就是修净度法门的人的话呢，他这一生一定要努力的应考，就是分分秒秒每天所遇到的一切境界都是可以让我们，也是一种考试，小考。好，那每一场都考得好的话呢，你的莲花就越来越大，将来呢你死的那一天就是你毕业的时候，你考上了十方世界的明星学校，就是到了极乐世界去。
Yang Bao, can you take a look at your chat box?
Okay.
Okay, so today's topic is everything in life is a test. Death is your graduation. So obviously, people who are reciting the Buddha's name or who are cultivating the Pure Land Dhamma doors, we work hard to take our tests. All states that we encounter every day are quizzes and tests. And if we can pass the tests with flying colors, then our lotus flowers will grow bigger and bigger. And on the day we die, that's the day we graduate. So then when we graduate, then we will be accepted to the name school, a reputable school in the world of 10 directions. That is the land of ultimate bliss.
毕业当天呢，是不是大家所害怕的那一天哦？那时候呢是这样的境界，大概是这样子，看个人的修为吧。那就是现在大家看到的呢，就是阿弥陀佛带着很多的菩萨，啊，还有极乐世界的医报也都来了，就是音乐啊，好光明啊，莲花啊，床幡啊等等的。 都来迎接我们去，所以那是一个很快乐的日子。所以念佛的人呢，他修得脚踏实地，修得好，死就是他最快乐的一天。轮回了无量劫，终于等到了这一天，可以脱离轮回，到极乐世界继续深造，让阿弥陀佛来教导我们怎么样一生成伴，能够到十方世界向十方诸佛学习。 然后得蒙佛受记而成佛，然后甚至可以呢还没有毕业都可以倒驾慈航到十方世界，乃至于娑婆世界度众生的，所以这一天是很快乐的日子。So
this is our graduation day. It's not a day of fear. It really depends on individual's cultivation. As people can see on the screen, this is a image that Amitabha Buddha brings a lot of bodhisattvas, all the dependent and proper retribution comes, meaning the music, the sound, lotus, banners, all arrive in front of us to welcome us to the land of ultimate bliss. So the day we pass away, it's actually a happy day. It's a day we graduate. It should be the happiest day of our life. So we have been transmigrating in the path of a sixth path, and we have born and died. And now we can go to the land of ultimate bliss to continue our study, to study from Amitabha, to learn from the Buddhas of the 10 directions. Even when we can cultivate until we realize Buddhahood there, or we can even before we graduate, we can reverse our compassionate bow to cross all the living beings over. So that should be a happy day or the happiest day of our life if we regard it like this.
那今天呢，就要讲的就是如何应考哦。那就来看看《楞严经》，告诉我们七趣轮回的两个主要原因。So
today we are going to talk about how to take our tests. In the Sharangama Sutra, in the section of the seven destinies, it talks about the two reasons we transmigrate in this world.
我们今世能够来做人呢，《楞严经》呢是这么说的，就是我们往昔哦，就是情想均等，就是我们这个感情跟理智这两方面是平均的。
According to the Sharangama Sutra, the reason why we can be born in the human path to become a person is because we have equal amount of emotions and reasons, 50-50% of each. That's why we can be reborn in a human path as a person.
那想为其主的话，就则明且聪，就是说你在往昔的话呢，你在想方面，就是你的理智方面呢，是作为你当时的，就是你在往昔呢，你主要呢常常都是比较理智多过你的情绪，你的情感的话呢，你今世就会长得很聪明啊，好，聪明又比较有智慧，学什么都很快。这样子的人是那个理智是超过他的情。
Okay, so if you look at the slide, it says that if you have more thoughts or more reasons than as your main constitution, then it means that you're more rational than emotional. So in this life, according to the sutra, you are more intelligent, smarter, and everything you learn, you can learn it very fast. So it your thoughts exceeds your emotions, or your rations exceeds your emotions.
那么这个现在刚才讲的是属于别业嘛，哈，就是我们每个人都是人呐，但是人当中有的比较聪明呀，有的比较愚笨嘛。那这是因为在往昔的关系了，想比较强就聪明，情比较重的人呢，他今世呢就会比较怎么样呢？择优且暗，就是他这个人呢就比较钝一点哦，比较怎么教都教不会呢。
Okay, so that was the individual retribution that we just talked about. So we are all born in the human path, and we're all human beings. However, some are more intelligent than others. Some are dumber than others. This all depends on how much emotions we have. If we have more emotions, one becomes dark and dull. One is duller. Say if someone is teaching another person, and this person just cannot learn it.
好，所以《楞严经正脉》书第八卷就是说，由习情想，感激冲顿，言君等者，总报之业也；言幽冥者，别报之业也。由所习情想，各在强弱，自有冲顿之意。
So according to the Zhengmai prologue of the Sharangama Sutra, it says due to the emotions and thought of past lives, one becomes keen or dull in this life. Next page.
好，我们现在来研究情跟想到底指的是什么啊。
So we are going to study what emotions and thoughts are.
情就是指的爱染恶情。也就是大家所熟悉的七情，喜怒哀乐爱恶欲。
Okay, so emotions, these are unconstructive or unwholesome emotions of love and defilement. These are the seven emotions of joy, anger, sadness, happiness, love, hatred, and desire.
这个情呢，是因为我们迷才会有情，所以情前面呢，多数是说迷情嘛，就是我们没有智慧，把虚妄的境界当真，对这些境界起了一种执着跟爱染心，然后就对你所执着的人事物呢，有了一种感情啊，发起种种的妄情啊，就是对你所执着的人事物呢，起了他的一举一动或者他的变化呢，因为你对他有爱染跟执着，有这种迷嘛，把它当真嘛，然后呢，你就会呢，因为这一切的人事物的变化，你起了一种喜怒哀乐爱恶欲的感情就出来了。所以楞严经说，因诸爱染发起妄情，情积不休，能生爱水。
Okay, so emotions comes from confusions. So we always say confused emotions in Chinese. So it means one will lack wisdom. They will take one takes all illusory states as real and true because one is attached due to their defiled love or defiled emotions. So then because of that, one pays attention to a person or a group of people's every movement. And because of confusion, one has attachment, one has desires. And therefore, as a result, because of either people, because of different matters, or because of different objects, one gives rise to seven emotions. These seven emotions are joy, anger, sadness, happiness, love, hatred, and desire. So the sutra text says, because of love and defilement, they produce the falseness of emotions. When these emotions accumulate without cease, they can create the fluids of love.
就是说呢，你们大家看哦，这个喜怒哀乐爱物欲，刚才我们读一开始的时候讲那个人在世间爱欲之中嘛，这个爱欲呢，就是指的就是这个七情了。但是七情之产生呢，都是爱欲两个导致的。你看我们乐极生悲，有没有乐到极点的喜极而泣，有没有啊？开心到极点，他也会掉眼泪啊，生爱水啦。如果呢难过的时候更是掉眼泪了，也是生爱水。所以反正呢有爱欲的人呢，他就是情很重，他就很容易呢就会让自己其实是堕沉沦的嘛。所以说爱不重不生娑婆，反正呢来当人的人每个人都是一般一般的，都是有情的啦，都是对好的事情也把感情放进去，不好的事也是一样，讨厌的情绪产生，那也是一个情啊。所以呢众生离不开这个情哦，人啊，尤其是人道。那所以现在我们今天讲的是要告诉这个要小心哦，大家如果是要到佛国的人呢，不要有这个感情是才是有办法保障你可以毕业的。
So you see these kind of seven emotions, joy, anger, sadness, happiness, love, hatred, and desires. We all have this. So the previous sutra passage, it says that amidst of love and desires, one comes along and goes along. These love and desires really refers to the seven emotions. The reason why we have these seven emotions comes from destructive emotions. So it says that when you're happy to an extreme, sadness comes. When you're happy, when you have joy to the extreme, you would shed tears. So these are all considered the fluids of love. So if one is sad, of course, they will shed tears. That is also considered the fluid of love. So these fluids of love will drag us down in transmigration. So it said that if we don't have strong emotional loves, we will not be born in the Lasaha world. The fact that we're in the Saha world means that we have half emotions and half reasons. When we have really good states, we have emotions according to the good state, the favorable states we have. If we have unfavorable states, bad states, undesirable states, we would also have emotions about it.
还有一点就是我们现代的人呢，就放不下这个网络，一天到晚好像手不离机，他不是手不离珠，他不是手不离念珠，他是手不离手机，那也是对手机产生了很强大的一种爱染心跟那个执着。所以如果研究这个楞严经，你就知道了，你的境界哦是在产生爱水的，你会越来越重，那就可能呢会保不住你的人生的。所以大家要自己要应该戒的就要戒。
Okay, 刚才漏两句。So, the fact that we are in the human path, we cannot be apart from emotions. So if we want to be born in the land of ultimate bliss, then we should transform destructive emotions so that we can graduate and be reborn in the land of ultimate bliss. Nowadays, people cannot put down or let go their cell phones or internet. Their hand is, they always have cell phones on their hands. In the old times, people always have recitation beads on their hands. So people have a very strong defiled attachment to our cell phones because of these attachments and these defiled states. It will produce fluids of love. And these fluids of love becomes heavy and will drag us down. So it might not guarantee that we can even be reborn as a human being again next life. So whatever we need to let go of, we should let go of. Whatever we should refrain from using, we should refrain from using.
好，想，现在讲的是想，想的就是叫可养善想。想在这里呢，不是妄想心的那个胡思乱想，是善的，是好的。那最重要的是这六个啦，六念，就是你所想的呢，跟这六方面是相应的。佛法僧戒天师，就是念佛、念法、念僧、念天、念师。
Oh, sorry, I forgot to unmute myself. Let me try again. So these are constructive, these are thoughts. These are constructive, wholesome thoughts of longing and yearning. It talks about six kinds of mindfulness, mindful of the Buddha, Dharma, Sangha, precepts, heaven, and giving.
经文是说,应诸可养,发明虚想。想机不休，能生圣气。
The sutra text says, because of longing and yearning, they invent the fallacy of discursive thought. When this reasoning accumulates without cease, it can create ascending vapors.
好，那就是说呢，我们心中有理想，很理智的想要往更好的地方去。然后呢，学佛的人当然就最好心里的念头不要忘了佛，不要忘了法，心里要跟佛法僧的这个道理相应，也要跟戒律相应。天呢，就是说有些人如果他想升天的话，他一天到晚修炼他都可以升天，这是往上的啦。反正就是想的方面是光明的，你譬如要升天的人他也要修十善嘛，所以他就很小心，为了升天他却就是要确定自己平时不要造十恶，然后他心地要善良，要帮助人啊。那这种人呢，就是在他的想很强，是想要升天，反正呢或者布施帮助别人，这些都是属于想机不休，能生圣气。就是如果你的这个理智方面很强烈哦，你遇到考验呢，你都能够呢，为了保住你的理想，你都可以呢，不要动那个情啊。这样子的人呢，他能够生殊胜的一种气，气就是很轻的气体嘛，你就可以往上升哦。
Okay, so this means that one has aspiration in their mind, in their thoughts. They want to go to good places. So in their mind, they never forget the Buddha, Dharma, Sangha, precepts, heaven, and giving. So their thoughts always correspond with these six thoughts. Or someone wish to be reborn in the heavens, they want to go upward, wherever the place they wish to go is bright and shining. So they will ensure that their mind is always radiating light. It's always positive, always very bright. So their thoughts, their rations will be stronger. if they want to say some people want to be reborn in the heavens. So it says that when this reasoning accumulates without cease, it can create ascending vapors. Vapors are very light. It calls you to ascend, to go upward.
我们现在来看呢，我是用偶益大师的楞严经文句哈，把它做成这个表，就是按照楞严经所说的啦哈。如果一个人呢，你做人的时候你是九想一情，你来世就会去到往上升哦，不是人道了，是飞仙。就是你临时当人的时候，你的理智哈，你的想，你的正念呢是有98%，你的感情呢，你的个人的迷情啊，有时有一种贪啊、爱啊、放不下那种迷情哈，只有10%的话呢，你来世会做飞仙。
Okay, so this is commentary from Great Master Oyi, and I have made it into a chart based on the text in the Sharangama Sutra. It says, as a human being, if we have 90% of thoughts and 10% of emotions, after we die, we will be reborn as flying immortals. Flying immortals are not human beings. Let's say when we are a person, when we are a human being right now, we maintain 90% of thought and 10% of emotions. These emotions include confusions, greed, anger, love, and so on. If you just have 10% of those, then you can become flying immortals after you pass away.
八想二情呢，就会投到大力鬼王这个道。
If you have 80% of thought, 20% of emotions, you will be reborn as great mighty ghost kings.
七想三情就是会变成飞行夜叉。
70% of thought and 30% of emotions, one becomes space traveling yakshas.
六想四情的人呢，他会转为地形罗刹。
60% of thought and 30% of emotions, one becomes earth traveling rakshasas.
然后他说，此皆善神种族，若加以善愿善心，则成护法八部众仪。也就是说，这一类的飞仙呢，乃至于这个最后一个地形罗刹，他们都是属于善神，就是来世你就可以往上升成善神之类的啦。但是如果你当人的时候呢，是有一种善的愿、跟善的心的话、来保持这种九想一情啊等等的，这样你将来还可以转世变成、天龙八部、佛教的护法善神。
Okay, so though these are the races of good spirits, if they indulge with good vows and good hearts, they will become the Dharma protectors of eightfold divisions. So these including the flying immortals, down to earth traveling Rakshasas, they will become wholesome spirits in their next life if they maintain good vows and good hearts, wholesome hearts, wholesome minds. They can become good spirits in their next life. Let's say if when they are a person, they have, they also maintain good vows, good hearts, then they, in the future, they can also become Dharma protectors of eightfold divisions. These are Dharma protectors in Buddhism.
那现在我们看呢，往下堕的情况是如何呢？
So let's take a look and see if we fall, what happens.
好，六情四想的人呢，会流入恒生。就是你当人的时候呢，你的情啊，大于你的想啊。就是说，你是有理智的人，可是你情太重了，就是你很容易发脾气啊，然后呢，恨，有恨啊，种种的。然后为了恨某些人呢，你可能会杀生哦。吃肉啊，这些都是 还有邪淫啊，或者是你已经没有理智了，你就奸淫他人啊，或者是婚外情啊，就搞这些邪淫的事情啊，就六情四想嘛，哈，很多现代的人呢，都是属于呢，他们就认为说，同居啊，还没有结婚就同居了，那这个都是属于呢，已经是道德方面是有问题了。然后呢，有的就很容易离婚啊，有的没有离婚也有婚外情啊，反正这一切呢，都是属于已经是情大于想。他会流入恒生，就是变成畜生了。
Okay, so next part is 60% of emotions and 40% of thoughts. One enters the animal realm. So, one has thoughts or rations, but they have lots of emotions, destructive emotions, meaning that they have anger, they have a lot of hatred. In order to hate someone, they may engage in killing or eating meat, or even sexual misconduct. When one has no rational thoughts, they could even commit offenses like raping, or even after they are married, they could have affairs. So 60% of emotions, 40% of thoughts, that's it describing these type of people. So nowadays, even people think that they can engage in sexual promiscuity. They live together before they're married. And according to Buddhism, these are ethical issues. People may get divorced or have affairs. All these are emotions. Is greater destructive emotions are greater than thoughts.
七情三想呢，就会升为恶鬼；八情二想呢，就会堕落有间地狱；九情一想就是无间地狱。如果一个人完全没有理智了，只是呢一味的呢，就是贪嗔痴太重了，他的情太重了，他完全是纯情的话呢，他。说纯情即尘会堕入阿鼻地狱。
Okay, 80% emotions, 20% thought. Sorry, 70% emotions, 30% thought. Bodies of hungry ghosts they become. 80% of emotions and 20% thought. They enter the intermittent hells. 90% emotions and 10% thoughts, one enters the relentless hells. So, and the last one is when they are possessed entirely of emotions, they sink into abhichi hells, that they only have pure destructive emotions. That's where they will end up with.
那我们最重要的，刚才我说了，把纸当毕业日嘛，就是想要去极乐世界嘛。想起极乐世界呢，按照楞严经卷第八呢，这里说的纯想咯，纯想呢是升天罢了，可是要到佛国还要加多三个条件哦。我们现在读一下经文。
Okay, so the most important thing is that we will treat the day we die as our graduation day if we want to go to the land of ultimate bliss.According to row A of the Sharangama Sutra, it says that when we have pure thoughts or pure rations, we will only be ascending to the heavens. But if we want to go to the land of ultimate bliss, there are three more conditions we need to practice.
请合掌，我们一起恭读：纯想即非，必生天上；若非心中，兼福兼慧。给予敬愿，自然心开，见十方佛，一切净土，随愿往生。
Okay, we would like to invite you to recite the passage with us. Please put your palms together. Indulge solely with thought, they will fly and can certainly be reborn in the heavens above. If they fly from the heart, and if they have blessings and wisdom, as well as pure vows,then their hearts will spontaneously open and they will see the Buddhas of the Ten Directions and all their pure lands and they will be reborn in whichever one they wish.
我们刚才讲的是七趣的其他六趣嘛，现在呢是讲的是第七个，就是天嘛。要升天的人一定要存想，就是他只有善没有恶，完全的实善哈。那这样子的人呢，他一定飞，好往上飞。
So what we just said were the six destinies among the seven destinies or the seventh half, and so now we're talking about the seventh one. This is the heavens. If one have pure thoughts, pure rations, and only have wholesomeness, they are pure in their ten wholesome deeds, then they will ascend to the heavens.
那这个存想呢，就是完全的念佛、念法、念僧、念戒、念天、念师，其中一样你能够保持住，都是可以升天的。
So this means that you're mindful of the Buddha, Dharma, Sangha, heavens, giving and precepts. If you can maintain mindfulness of any one of the six, you can be reborn in the heavens.
若非心中兼福兼慧，给予敬愿，就是说你是一个很理智的人，是持戒的人，是不杀不偷，不邪淫，不妄语，不饮酒等等的，这十善你都持得很好，但是你还能够呢兼于 还能够加上呢修福跟修慧，跟能够发清净的愿呢，或者发求往生的愿，这种人呢自然心开，就是有的祖师说呢，自然心开就是你的如来藏心开显，就是一个人能够存想，譬如他念佛也好，或者专门念法念咒都好，他又能够修福修慧发清净愿呢，他总有一天一定会藏心开显，或者是你也可以说临终的时候你就可以见十方佛，一切净度随愿往生，就看你这辈子是想要去哪一个净度呢，都可以满你的愿。
Okay, so these people are very rational. They uphold the precepts. They do not engage in killing, stealing, sexual misconduct, lying, or taking intoxicants. They don't do any of those. And additionally, if they continue to practice blessings and wisdom, as well as making pure vows, then it says that their hearts will spontaneously open. They will see the Buddhas of the ten directions. So according to the patriarchs, this means that their mind and their Tathagata's nature will be revealed. Let's say one recites sutras, mantras, Buddha's name, their mind of treasury will open and be revealed. They can, in this life, or at the end of this life, they can see Buddhas, they can be reborn in the Pure Land, and their vows to be reborn in the Pure Land will be fulfilled.
我们现在下存想，刚才我也是现在看这个表，存想就是要念佛、念法、念僧、念戒、念天、念师。
Okay, so I'd like to explain this chart. Indulge solely with thoughts means one is mindful of the Buddha, Dharma, Sangha, precepts, heaven, and giving.
兼福修福啊，是修哪一种福呢？就是布施、持戒、忍辱、精进、禅定这五度的福德，或者是十六观经所介绍的三福，或者你供养三宝，或者供僧、供佛、供法、这一种呢、供养三宝的都是属于福，修福的。
Okay, so we want to be cultivating blessings. Well, what kind of blessings do we want to cultivate? These are the five paramitas of giving, upholding precepts, practicing patience, practicing samadhi, and practicing wisdom. or the three blessings mentioned in the 16 Visualization Sutra, or we make offerings to the three jewels, making offerings to the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha. All these are considered cultivating blessings.
这个三福跟共生，好，这一段呢，我应该是下个星期天会跟大家讲讲，因为下个星期是一个好日子，礼拜天呢刚好是农历七月十五盂兰盆节，然后呢又是那一天就是属于呢可以修呢孝道跟共生的好日子，那就是属于修这个三福了，还有这个共生，这个等下个星期才跟大家讲讲。
So next week we will be talking about the three kinds of blessings and offering to the Sangha. We will do that next Sunday, which is a very good day. That's the 15th day of the seventh month. That happens to be the Ulambana day. So all these are considered cultivating filiality to your parents. These are really good days that you can plant the three blessings and make offerings to the Sangha.
那慧呢？修慧是修什么呢？就是六度的最后一度叫般若，般若等等的很多大乘经典所讲的，让我们开智慧的那一些法，还有听经闻法也是修慧。
Okay, so cultivating wisdom. This is the last one of the six paramitas. This is prajna, studying the Mahayana sutras, studying the Dharma that will open your wisdom. So listening to the Dharma sutra lectures, all these are considering the practice of wisdom.
刚才说情呢，前面是加一个字叫迷嘛。然后想呢，前面可以加一个字叫觉，也就是说一个人如果他迷多呢，他一定感情很重的，如果一个人觉悟的多啊，他一定是比较正念的，所以叫觉想。
Okay, and then so earlier when we talk about emotions, in Chinese we said confused emotions. If the emotions are destructive, it causes confusion. So we always say confused emotions. So we add confusion in front of emotions. What do we add in front of thoughts? Means awakening or insight or enlightening thoughts. So when one is very confused, one has more destructive emotions. If one has lots of rations, lots of thoughts, then one tends to be awakened for these states.
那所以对我们来说，我们如果哈，刚才我讲的那个迷呢，它的境界是暗的啦，觉是光明的啊，正念呢，这是光明的，一个是阳，一个是阴嘛。那所以如果我们要照破心中的黑暗跟迷惘，我们要靠智慧，所以这个慧方面呢，它是属于光明跟觉，它会保住我们的正念，所以这个有关般若的方面呢，我想介绍的是离世间品的第八种清净慧，我想如果有时间下个星期再讲这个方面呢，真的对我们很重要，很多人就是众生就是对般若不了解，就把一切的本来是空的境界当真来去追求，来去苦恼，然后造了很多罪孽，还要受七趣的轮回之苦。所以我们要脱离轮回的人，一定要以般若为导，活着呢，每天要张开双眼，不要走错路。
So to us, confusion means darkness. Thoughts or rations means light, means brightness. One is yin and one is yang. If we want to break through the darkness in our hearts, we must practice wisdom so that our hearts is filled with light and awaken and insights and awakening. So based on or regarding prajna, regarding the aspects of prajna, I want to talk about pure wisdom from leaving the world chapter in the Avatamsaka Sutra. We will leave this to next week. This is really important, is because living beings do not truly understand what prajna is. So they take what is originally empty as real. They pursue it, falling into these states, and suffer from being reborn in the seven destinies. If we want to leave the sufferings of the seven destinies behind, we need to practice prajna so that we will have wisdom, so we can open our eyes and not tread the wrong path.
第三个条件呢，非常重要。哦，修福修慧大家都知道是一定要修了，但是呢，这个是推动我们修的圆满，还是要靠清净的愿，叫净愿。这个净愿呢，有两个解释，一个就是说发往生净土的愿，第二个呢，要常随佛学，发广大的愿。你看《华严经》，这个十回向品呢，就有一开始就提到了，菩萨摩诃萨有不可思议大愿，充满法界。那菩萨呢，每做一件小善事，他都发在这个小本华严，我们所诵的华严经呢，他每做一个布施，他都要发十个愿。好，大本的呢就无量无边的愿了。反正呢，菩萨们呢，所谓的回向就是发大愿，所以而且所发的大愿要越来越广大，充满整个法界的，那就是很快很快可以回去我们的自性哦，就可以见性成佛。所以我们要成佛呢，是要用大愿来推动我们的，因为这个世界上只有两个力量最大，一个是业力，一个叫愿力。假如你的愿力不够强大，你就会被你的业力拉着走。
Okay, so the third condition is very important. We all know that we want to cultivate blessings and wisdom, and what really propel us to cultivate blessings and wisdoms is actually our pure vows. It says pure vows, these are seeking rebirth in the pure land, always follow the steps of the Buddhas to make great vows. So in the Avatamsaka Sutra, in the 10 transference chapter, at the very beginning, it says that Bodhisattvas has made inconceivable vows that fill up the entire Dharma realm or pervades the entire Dharma realm. So every little thing, every little wholesome deed that Bodhisattvas engage in, including giving, they will make 10 great vows. So this is in the shorter sutra, but in the greater chapter, these vows that Buddhas and Bodhisattvas made are limitless and boundless. So these are the vows that Bodhisattvas make. They are great, they are vast, they are boundless. So that in practicing this way, we can quickly return to our inherent nature. We could see our nature and become a Buddha. So we practice based on our great vows, which really propel us, give us the impetus to practice. So there are two kinds of powers in this world. One is the power of karma. The other one is the power of vows. Those are the biggest powers. If your power of vows is not greater than your power of karma, then you are dragged along in this world.
今天晚上呢，我只剩一分钟了，可是我要讲的就是讲这个六念纯想的其中一个是念佛。
We only have 1 minute left, and so we want to talk about the pure thoughts. We talked about the six kinds of mindfulness earlier. I want to talk about mindfulness of the Buddha.
请大家看《楞严经》卷第五，若众生心忆佛、念佛，现前当来必定见佛，去佛不远，不假方便，自得心开。 如染香人身有香气，此则名曰香光庄严。
If living beings remember the Buddha and are mindful of the Buddha, certainly they will see the Buddha now and in the future. They will never be far from the Buddha, and their minds will awaken by themselves without the aid of expedience. A person who has been near incense will carry a fragrance on this person. It is the same in this case. It is called an adornment of fragrant light.
念佛是怎么念呢？按照楞严经大势至菩云大势至圆通章哈，大势至菩萨圆通章呢，他是说我们这些众生的心啊，如果常常会想到佛啊，会念佛的话呢，不管现在或者将来，你一定可以见到阿弥陀佛的，尤其是念佛人嘛，因为呢，他说你不但能见佛，去佛不远呐、啊，就是可以说呢，你离成佛也不远呐、啊。不假方便，根本也不需要呢。如果你时间不够，你单靠念阿弥陀佛，不用靠其他方便呢，你都有办法靠一句南无阿弥陀佛，让你修到什么程度呢？心开，好，心开。我刚才说了，就是藏心开显，也就是开悟的意思啊。可以念到乃至于证到那个理一心不乱的话呢，是可以破无明的。他说，念佛的境界是这样的：如染香人身有香气。就是像一个呢每天呢在那个香房里面哦制造那个香嘛，他每天呢在这个香里面那边待着呢，他身体一走出那个香房呢，他都有香气的。也就是说，念佛的人念多了哈、哦、你念佛的地点，你家都会有一股香气的，然后甚至呢你家都会有光明的。在道场也好，在家都好，只要勤劳念南无阿弥陀佛，你就是天天在怎么样呢？庄严你的家，变成一个香光的道场。因为念佛就是香光庄严的一个很殊胜的法门。
Okay, so we want to recite the Buddha's name. So how do we recite?According to the Sharangama Sutra, it says that if living beings are always mindful of the Buddha, whether it's now or in the future, they will certainly see the Buddha. They do not only see the Buddha, they can also have their hearts open, which means they will be awakened, which means that if you only recite the Buddha's name and recite single-mindedly to a point,that your nature of your Tathagata's treasury will be revealed. If you recite the Buddha's name to a point that you are one heart and confused in principle, it can really break your ignorance. So it says that it's just like a person who has been in the incense making room. They're near the incense, they will carry a fragrance on this person. If you're making incense in the room, when you leave that room, you will have fragrance on your body. So the same thing with reciting the Buddha's name. The place that you reside, the house where you reside, is bound to have fragrance and light. So if you can diligently recite the Buddha's name, it is really like adorning your own house.Like adorning a monastery. It's filled with light and fragrance. It is really a supreme Dhamma door to practice.
最后，大家看《佛说无量寿经》的一个偈颂。这个偈颂呢，是法藏菩萨还没有发四十八大愿之前，在佛前呢发，他出了家，他发的愿，他本来是国王嘛。我们大家一起来读这短短的偈颂：无事得佛，普行此愿，一切恐惧为作大安。
Okay, so now I'd like to take everyone to look at this verse in the Buddha Speaks of Infinite Life Sutra. This is a verse that Dhammakara means the previous Amitabha's life.He hasn't made the 48 vows. He was still a king, Dhammakara. He made this vow. He said, I vow that when I realize Buddhahood, I shall fulfill this vow universally to all fear-ridden beings, I shall give them great peace.
阿弥陀佛还没有成佛呢，他出了家就是为了成佛。他说我发誓呢，将来我成佛，我一定要做这件事情。一切众生不管他处在任何的恐惧当中，我一定可以让他得大安。只要他肯找我，我一定让他大安。
Okay, so Amitabha Buddha said this before he realized Buddhahood. He said he leaves the home life, Gamakara, leaves the home life in order to realize Buddhahood. He said, I certainly want to become a Buddha. So he made this vow. He said, to fear-ridden beings, people who have lots of fear in their mind, as long as they look for me, I shall give them great peace.
不晓得大家还要听吗？还是接下来的这个留给下一次。
I don't know if people want to continue or we should save this for next time.
勇法师不晓得可以再讲一点吗？
那个 chat box, so please continue, 然后要听想听。愿意听，
阿弥陀佛。好，那我继续讲一下，为什么阿弥陀佛可以让我们大安呢？就因为他的名号功德是不可思议的。我们看一下这一部经，叫做《佛说阿弥陀佛根本秘密神咒经》。
So, why could Amitabha Buddha give us great peace? It comes from the Buddha speaks of Amitabha Buddha's fundamental secret mantra sutra.This explains why.
又舍利弗，阿弥陀佛名号具足无量无边，不可思议，甚深秘密，殊胜微妙，无上功德，所以者何？
Furthermore, Shariputra, Amitabha Buddha's name is replete with limitless, boundless, inconceivable, profound, secret, supreme, subtle, wonderful, unsurpassed merit and virtue.Why is that so?
好，就阿弥陀佛他的名号哦，或者你念南无阿弥陀佛也好，或者阿弥陀佛都好，反正他的名字呢，就本身呢、哦、就有无量无边、不可思议、甚深秘密、殊胜微妙、无上的功德。这个功德实在太广大，不可思议了。
So whether your Amitabha Buddha's name, whether it's Amitabha or Namo Amitabha, his name has limitless, boundless, inconceivable, profound, secret, supreme, subtle, wonderful, unsurpassed, merit and virtue. His merit and virtue is too vast and too inconceivable.
原因在哪里呢?
What's the reason?
阿弥陀佛三字中有十方三世一切诸佛一切诸菩萨声闻阿罗汉一切诸经陀罗尼神咒无量横法
So why is that? The three syllables of Amita is replete with all Buddhas, all Bodhisattvas, sound hearer, arhats, all sutras, dharanis, spiritual mantrasAnd limitless dharmas of practices of the ten directions of the three periods of time.
对，阿弥陀佛这三个字哦，简简单单，阿弥陀三个字，已经涵盖了南无什么十方三世一切诸佛，以十方三世一切的菩萨，十方三世一切的声闻，出果、二果、三果乃至四果阿罗汉，还有十方三世一切的经典，一切的陀罗尼，一切的神咒，无量无边的修行法门，都含藏在他的三个字里面，阿弥陀。
Okay, so Amita, three syllables are very, very simple. However, it encompasses all the Buddhas, Bodhisattvas in the ten directions of three periods of time. It also encompasses all the sound hearers, the Shravakas, from first stage, second stage, third stage, to the fourth stage, Arhats. It also includes all the sutras, dharanis, spiritual mantras, all are encompassed and limitless, boundless dharmas of practices of the three periods of time, 10 directions, all are encompassed in these three syllables.
所以呢，释迦牟尼佛他继续说：“是故彼佛名号即是为无上真实自极大乘之法，即是为无上殊胜清净了义妙恒，即是为无上最胜微妙陀罗尼，而说偈曰。”
Therefore, as such, this Buddha's name is known as the unsurpassed, true and actual ultimate Mahayana Dharma.It is also known as the unsurpassed, supreme, pure, complete meaning of the wonderful practice. Also known as the unsurpassed, most supreme, subtle, wonderful Dharani. Hence, the Buddha speaks the following verse.
我记得以前我们刚出家的时候呢，上人呢有告诉我们，他希望成立五大宗，他要我们呢自己写一篇文章，你到底要选哪一宗？那时候我才出家，我都不知道选哪一宗才好。想来想去呢，最容易的就是念佛。他说，如果你选念佛的话呢，我就给你24小时，一天到晚一直念南无阿弥陀佛。如果你选禅宗，我给你24小时一直参禅。如果你选密宗，24小时一直持咒。如果你选教宗，24小时一直讲经说法。然后，所以我。算来算去呢，我就觉得讲经说法一直讲也是很辛苦，而且我也不会讲啊，刚出家哪里懂。然后禅宗呢打坐我也不行，所以我就写了净土宗，然后就是要20小时一直这样子修的。那过了不久，后来在1994年我最后一次见到上人的时候呢，他就说你们年轻人要站起来，我已经老了。他对我说，因为当时是另外一个法师带我去见上人的，那上人在病中嘛， 他坐起来就跟我说，他说年轻人要站起来，我已经老了，耳朵都聋了。我当时内心想呢，上人呢根本一定会好的了，然后我没想到他半年后就走了。可是当时他跟我讲了这个之后，他还说你们以后要修行的。哇，我听到这一个呢，我心里也是很奇怪耶，我已经出家，当时已经出家5年了，到我们在道场做早晚课啊，然后呢大悲忏啊，所有功课跟到底，又出播，又做很多的工作，这样不是修行吗？为什么我都出家5年了，他还讲以后你们要修行的？我当时真的搞不清楚师父的意思。可是后来慢慢我想应该就是刚出家他所说的，我希望成立五大宗，让你们呢选其中一宗24小时专修啊。那也就是说，譬如你选净土宗，你如果有这个好因缘可以24小时专念南无阿弥陀佛的话，那你真的就是在专修道修念佛了，你不攀缘其他事情，你心里只有一佛念佛啊。你知道你在修什么吗？就是这段所说的，你在修的是无上真实最至极的大乘法，你也是在修无上殊胜清净了义、啊、就最圆满意义的妙恒，而且也是呢在修咒，也是在持咒，因为它就是一种无上最殊胜微妙的陀罗尼。阿弥陀三个字就是陀罗尼，就是咒，而且不是普通的陀罗尼，它是无上最殊胜微妙的陀罗尼。
Okay, so this is what the Buddha said. I remember when I just left the home lifeI remember Venerable Master said that we want to establish the 5 schools. So he said, all of you write an essay, then you can decide or pick or select which school you want to cultivate. So I was thinking back and forth. The easiest one is probably reciting the Buddha's name. Venerable Master said that if you want to recite the Buddha's name, you want to cultivate the Pure Land Dhamma Door, then you can have time and space to be reciting the Buddha's name from morning to night, 24 hours a day. If you choose to practice Chan school, then you will investigate Chan 24 hours a day. If you choose to practice the secret sacred Dharma doors, then you will be reciting mantras from morning to night, 24 hours a day. If you select the teaching school, then you will be speaking Dharma, lecturing on sutras 24 hours a day. And I thought, well, lecturing on sutras and speaking Dharma, that's really hard for me because I was very new. I just left the home life. I didn't really understand much. And then investigating Chan, that was even harder for me because I was very new in monastic life. So those are 24 hours of cultivation, 24/7. And I thought the easiest one for me is probably reciting the Buddha's name. So in 1994, I had a chance to speak with Venerable Master, and he said, "You all of you young people must stand up on your own. I am old now." I remember Venerable Master was sick back then. He sat up from his bed and said, "I am old and I am deaf now." And I thought that he would recover from his health problems, but little did I know that he passed away within half a year. So he told us, "All of you in the future, you all have to cultivate." And at the time I was thinking, well, I already leave the home life for 5 years. I follow morning recitation, evening recitation. I go to the Great Compassion and Repentance. I do community work for 5 years. Isn't this cultivation? Why do you say we all have to cultivate in the future? I wasn't very clear on what he meant before. Because he said, "Oh, we want to establish 5 schools. We want to cultivate specifically this particular Dhamma door for 24 hours a day. If you choose the Pure Land, then you can recite the Buddha's name 24 hours a day. And if you do that, it's the same as exclusively cultivating the Pure Land door. So if you are mindful of the Buddha all the time, then this is mindful of the Buddha all the time, you're reciting the Buddha's name all the time, then it is like this passage, you're cultivating the unsurpassed, true and actual ultimate Mahayana Dharma. It is known as the unsurpassed, supreme, pure, complete meaning of the wonderful practice. It's also, you are also cultivating this unsurpassed, most supreme, subtle, wonderful Dharani. It's not just any Dharani, it's the most supreme, subtle and wonderful Dharani.
所以呢，佛就讲了这首偈颂，我们一起读：阿至十方三世佛，弥至一切诸菩萨，陀至八万诸圣教，三至之中四具足。
So the Buddha said, the syllable A refers to the Buddhas of the 10 directions and 3 periods of time. The syllable Mi refers to all Bodhisattvas.The syllable Ta refers to 84,000 sage teachings of the sages. These 3 syllables are hence regarded as complete.
阿、啊，现在讲这个阿弥陀这个三个字就是陀罗尼嘛。现在解释阿、啊、的意思呢，就是十方三世佛，弥呢就是一切的菩萨，包括圣人，陀呢就是八万四千诸圣教，就是八万四千法门，就是陀字，也就是说，他说这个三字之中是具足，就是表示说，单单阿弥陀就已经代表了最圆满的三宝，阿代表佛宝，弥代表僧宝，陀代表什么呢？法宝。所以阿弥陀，你念南无阿弥陀佛，你就是念整个三宝，你就是在修一切的法门，你就是在念一切的佛号，念一切的菩萨圣号。
Okay, so Amita, the 3 syllables are considered Dharani. So A refers to the Buddhas of the 10 directions and 3 periods of time. Mi refers to all Bodhisattvas.Ta refers to all the teachings of sages, which means are the 84,000 Dhamma doors. It also means that Amita repeats with, it refers to the most complete and perfect 3 jewels, because you got the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha in the 3 syllables. So when you recite Amitabha Buddha's name, you are reciting the 3 jewels, you're mindful of the 3 jewels, you're cultivating all Dhamma doors, you're mindful of all the Buddhas, bodhisattvas at the same time.
功德是这样子的，舍利弗，若有众生闻说阿弥陀佛不可思议功德，欢喜踊跃，自心称念，深信不懈，于现在身受无比乐，或转贫贱，获得富贵。
So the merit and virtue of reciting the Buddha's name, being mindful of the Buddha, is as such. Shariputra, if they are living beings who, upon hearing Amitabha's inconceivable merit and virtue, is elated, jumps for joy, single-mindedly recites, bring forth profound faith, as well as not being relaxed, being lax, these beings in this very life shall experience incomparable bliss. Those in poverty will attain wealth and nobility.
这个我不解释了哈。再来，获得国免宿业所追病患之苦，或转短命得寿延长，或怨家变横得子孙繁荣，身心安乐，如意满足，如是功德不可称计。
For those who are saddled with long-standing karmic illnesses, will attempt fruition to avoid these retributions.Or those who have short lifespans will enjoy longevity. Or those hated by enemies shall have prosperous descendants. Those beings shall be peaceful and joyous in body and mind, with all their wishes fulfilled and satisfied. Such merit and virtue is incalculable.
假如你过去呢也造了很多罪业，可能今世你必须要受一些大病之苦哦。你念南无阿弥陀佛可以免除这种苦，短命变长寿啊。本来呢，你将来的子子孙孙呢，也许呢是冤亲债主来投胎的，可是因为你念佛啊，那些冤家本来要来投胎呢，他都不会啦，放过你了。然后来的呢是好的，跟你有缘的，反正呢。这念佛的功德是无量无边不可思议的。
So let's say in the past life you have created lots of negative karma. When you recite the Buddha's name, your short lifespan will turn into longevity. Or let's say you may have children's, grandsons, offsprings. They may be reborn from your past karmic debtors.You recite the Buddha's name, perhaps they will let you go. And those who come to be reborn as your descendant will be the wholesome ones who can repay your kindness. So the merit and virtue of reciting the Buddha's name is limitless and boundless.
那身心安乐如意满足，就是你心中有什么愿，你求阿弥陀佛，他一定帮你过关，让你越来越进步。向佛求任何的愿，他都会满你的愿，因为他说过嘛，一切恐惧为作大安。我们活在这个时代呢，真的是很多的灾难啊，又有这个疫情，所以呢，这种种的灾难呢，我们怎么去面对呢？你要记得，阿弥陀佛说，一切恐惧为作大安。然后我们现在呢，我想带领大家一起念十声南无阿弥陀佛哦，来祈祷阿弥陀佛赐予我们全球人类得到大安，然后灾疫呢能够减轻，很快能够呢雨过天晴，人心向善。我们等一下做一小小的回向。
Okay, and so I mean, the next says that those beings should be peaceful and joyous in body and mind with all their wishes fulfilled and satisfied. So anything we can ask help from Amitabha Buddha, then we can pass our test. We can improve, we can progress.On the path of our cultivation, because Amitabha Buddha had made this vow before he left the home life. It says to all these fear-ridden living beings, I shall give them peace and happiness. I shall give them peace. So in this world, we have lots of disasters, and now we have this pandemic, the global pandemic right now. How do we face it? We can ask Amitabha to help us.He says that to all fear-ridden living beings, I shall give them peace. So next, I'd like to lead everyone in reciting Amitabha Buddha's name 10 times, hoping that Amitabha Buddha, praying to Amitabha Buddha, that he can give us great peace, that the pandemic will be over very soon, that people will attend to our goodness. So we will have a short transference passage that we will recite.
哎，那个十六观经有讲到呢，阿弥陀佛身上所放的光呢，是在摄取念佛众生不舍，也就是谁念佛，他身上的光就来照你。然后，所以呢，我们现在念佛呢，是希望阿弥陀佛的光是照整个法界，包括整个全球，然后大家都能够离苦得乐，得到大安。
So in the 16 Visualization Sutra, it says the light shines forth from Amitabha Buddha's body while gathering living beings who are mindful of the Buddha. So without letting go. So now when we're reciting the Buddha's name, Amitabha's light will shine on us. His light will pervade the entire Dharma realm, of course, including the entire globe. So that all living beings will leave suffering and attain bliss. He will bestow great peace on us.
我们一起，大家来念南无阿弥陀佛。南无阿弥陀佛。南无阿弥陀佛。哎呐。摩阿弥陀佛，南摩阿弥陀佛，哎南摩阿弥陀佛，哎南摩阿弥陀佛。哎呐，摩阿弥陀佛，哎呐，摩阿弥陀佛，哎呐，摩阿弥陀佛，南无。阿弥陀佛，我们一起回向，唯愿三宝直光普照，全球灾疫悉数消除，愿诸世界雨顺风调，物阜民安，诸缘适宜，人心向善，皆发菩提，福慧齐修，悲智双运，摄取功德普利一切，同生净土，速成正觉。
We pray that the three jewels will shine the light of kindness everywhere, so that global disasters and pandemic will be eliminated quickly and completely. May all worlds be blessed with favorable weather, people enjoy peaceful lives in flourishing economy, and all circumstances in accord with their wishes. May people tend toward goodness, resolve upon Bodhi, cultivate both blessings and wisdom, apply both compassion and wisdom appropriately, and gather in merit and virtue to benefit all living beings.So that we can together be reborn in the Pure Land and realize Buddhahood quickly.
我们刚才呢一起研究了一个差不多一个半钟头的法，我们是在纯想念法，同时也是在修福修慧，也是发清净愿回向给全球，大家一起同生净土。
So now we just study the Dharma together for about 1 hour or so. And you can say that we're all engaged in the state of pure thoughts. We are studying, we are mindful of the Dharma, cultivating blessings and wisdom together, as well as making pure vows. So we can all be reborn in a land of ultimate bliss together.
我们现在可以回向了。
Okay.So we would like to make transference now. Yong法师, 有没有 announcement? Dhamma Master Yong, do we have any announcement before we make transference?
No, not today, because next Sunday, Dhamma Yang will continue to speak. I think people know. 下礼拜天杨法师会继续讲法。阿弥陀佛。
OK, 那我们这边佛殿我们就回向，请大家合掌。
愿以此功成庄严佛净土，上报四重恩，下济三途苦。若有千万者，须发菩提心，须知当生极乐国，顶礼莲沙。
Thank Thomas Yang's wonderful talk and also Thomas Jingjing's translation. We'll continue next Sunday. 感恩那些杨法师精彩的讲法，还有金晶法师的翻译。下礼拜天继续。阿弥陀佛。
阿弥陀佛。Thank you, Dhamma Master Yong, for putting the talk together.
阿弥陀佛。